Ladies and gentlemen, I salute you once again in the name of the Almighty. Daniel Walusimbi is my name, the legitimate FUFA president. I would like to welcome you to our episode 16 of the Football in Captivity series. I hope you will still find it so interesting, enlightening, and educative. I also hope that you will still share this information with your networks. As promised in our previous episode, today's episode is about the role of the Ugandan courts of law in the continued persistent existence of these illegalities, where Scoreline Investments Limited continues to hold out as FUFA, the national association. You know, in Uganda, they say that akadukiro ko munako court niye kibuzo kino kijja eri gwe nange dala court ze Uganda zikyali kadukiro ko munako. You answer get them yonang. This in English, it means that the only place of refuge for the poor is the courts of law. But the question we should pose to ourselves is that, is the Ugandan courts of law still the only place of refuge for the poor? I highly doubt. But anyway, we should understand that the role of the courts of law is to provide justice and protection for those who seek it. And we should also understand that justice delayed, it is justice denied. And it's really so unfortunate that the Ugandan courts of law have really denied the football families and the Ugandan public the justice that it so greatly deserves. Chinyamiza. Tikotize Uganda. Tizitu wade families zafe. Ne public. Tebatu wade buenkanya. Talabuvale tunonye banga inoliona. Ilateba nabutua. You know, we really find it so funny that 4 years, it has taken now 4 years and you are still counting, that a matter brought before court, a matter of public interest, can take the Ugandan courts of law more than 4 years. It is really so sad. We launched a case against the Attorney General of Uganda, National Council of Sports, for the fraudulent, persistent fraudulent schemes that are going on, where the unsuspecting public continues to be defrauded. But up to now, they have not come to the conclusion of these cases. And we have so many other cases, even about the certificate of incorporation as a trustee against the ministers. But up to now, they have not concluded these cases. And the unsuspecting public continues to be defrauded. And taxpayers' monies continues to be swindled through these illegal entities. It be some understanding that somebody can, how a judge can adjourn a case of a matter of public interest to close to a year. It is really so sad. Adjournment after adjournment, adjournment after adjournment, adjournment after adjournment. We went into mediation with the National Council of Sports and the Attorney General. The mediations failed. Those 2 years back. But we are here, still here, adjournment after adjournment. It is really so unfortunate. But as I said, we are law-abiding citizens and no one can beat sportsmen when it comes to following the law. We understand the law is a process. We shall follow the law to the dot. And we know that the ultimate result is that truth will prevail. So we are very confident that the end result we know. But it's so unfortunate that court has allowed these illegalities to continue to exist to date, because they cannot conclusively determine those cases that are before them. I would like to take this opportunity to call upon the new Chief Justice, Owini Doro, to try to make the judicial system to handle matters of public interest always expeditiously in the best interest of the public. And again, I would like to let everyone know that very soon we shall be engaging the Chief Justice's office to see that they can handle our matter expeditiously for the greater good of our beautiful game and for the protection of the unsuspecting public, and also for the sake of our taxpayers' monies that continues to be swindled through these illegal entities. So, very soon, and I would say conclusively next week, our formal complaint and the petition is coming to your office as the Chief Justice to see that you protect Ugandans and taxpayers' monies. For now, I'll end here my episode 16 of the Football in Captivity series, and I hope to catch up with you next week as we shall be talking about the role of Parliament in this continued existence of these illegalities. So, ladies and gentlemen, have a blessed day. I always remain Daniel Walusimbi, your legitimate FUFA president. Ciao.